Now, if we can get back to this case. Mrs. Thelma Harper was operating the vacuum, and some keys belonging to Mrs. Naomi Harper jammed the motor. Now, do you have anything to say in your defense?
I most certainly do, Your Honor. I would like to call my star witness, Vinton Harper.
I object.
To what?
Is it legal in this state for a man to testify against his own mother? His own flesh and blood, the woman who brought him into this world, who wiped his nose and diapered his behind before Pampers. Is that legal?
Yes, it is.
Just asking.
Go on.
Thank you very much, sir. Now, baby, did you lend that vacuum cleaner to your mama?
Yes.
Had she ever used that cleaner before?
No, nobody had ever used it before.
Now, I want you to think very carefully, sweetheart. Before your mama started to use that vacuum cleaner, did she read the instruction booklet?
Oh, good heavens, I don't need instructions. I know that rug like the back of my hand.
But you didn't know my vacuum cleaner, and I think she used it wrong and burnt up the rug and ruined my cleaner all at the same time.
May I have a chance to defend myself here, Your Honor? May I please call Vinton Harper?
He's my witness.
He's my son.
Well, he is my husband.
It is my courtroom. Isn't it? Call Vinton Harper.
Vinton, come here.
Oh, honey.
Bye, Skeeter. I'll miss you.
Get over here. Now, Vinton Harper. What exactly is it that you do for a living?
Well, I'm a locksmith, Mama. You know that.
Just answer the question.
I'm a locksmith.
He's a locksmith. Is it not true that over the past 2 months, you have made 4 sets of keys for one Naomi Harper?
Yes, I did.
Uh-huh. Why?
Because she kept losing them all over the house.
That's it. Case dismissed. Give me the money, you lame brain.
Because you keep sucking them up in your vacuum cleaner, you old bitch.
Is she allowed to use that kind of language in court?
How many vacuum cleaners did your mama break in one day?
Well, two. But...
Two.
And tell you how long has this rug been in our family before she committed sabotage?
As long as I can remember.
Right. I'm not going to stand up for her, are you?
He's going to love me
more.
He doesn't love you more.
He doesn't love you.
Mrs. Harper and Mrs. Harper, you are both found in contempt of court. The fine is $100 each. If anybody speaks, moves, or even blinks, it goes up another $200. Is that clear? Excellent. Now, because I think you're both responsible for the negligence, I order that you each pay your own damages. Court is recessed. This case is closed. I'm going out for a beer. As for you, Vinton Harper, if you have a half a brain in your head, you'll join me.